Hey, what's up guys, welcome to my new video. And in this video I'm gonna discuss one problem which is called reader-writer problem. So in this I will just show you the code and I will just explain that code to you. So this is the code, and I have written this code in C language along with OpenMP. So OpenMP, using OpenMP you can use multiple threads at the same time, and that is what we are doing here. So I will start this code from the main. So from here the program starts. So I've defined ID and number of threads. So initially I'm setting the number of threads to 8. So there will be 8 threads in this program. Then I'm calling a function called number. So in number I'm accepting the number of readers and writers. So it is been accepted from the user. So you can give any number here, but it should be less than 8 because we have 8 threads. Then I'm calling a function called initWrite. So in initWrite we are gonna initialize something. So what we are initializing, the buffer. So this buffer we have declared in the global memory. So this is the global memory, and it is of size 10. So 10 characters can be in the buffer. So we are initializing it, so we are asking user to write something inside the buffer. Next, after initializing the buffer, we are initializing the log. So these are two logs. So first one is for write and second one is for read. So these are declared right at the top of the program. So here, these two lines have been declared earlier, so they are for the log on reader and writer. So after initializing the log, we are entering into the parallel section. So in this section, the execution of the single thread in the main will be divided among 8 threads. So each and every thread will execute individually. So in pragma omp for, each iteration, say I equal to 0, will be executed on id 0. So thread 0 will execute the first iteration, and then id 1 will execute second, id 3rd will execute third iteration, and so on. So now we are assigning the particular task to some threads. So nre is the number of reader and rw is number of writer. So the number of threads having their id less than re. So suppose we have 4 readers and 5 writers, so that's 9. No, we have 4 readers and 3 writers. So the id of the thread having their id less than 4 will read the content, and the threads having id greater than 4 will write content to the buffer. So first of all, suppose thread number 2 comes, and there are 4 readers. So thread 2 has id 2, so it is less than the total number of readers. So it will call reader function. So as soon as it call reader function, the control comes here and it will call another function called start read. So in start read, we set lock on reader, then we increment nr, which is initially 0. Then we compare if nr is equal to 1, because at instance there should be only one reader inside this. So we are checking that if nr is 1, then we are setting lock on writer, and then we are releasing the lock on reader. So at a time only one reader is allowed to come, and after that the control will come in reader and it will read the content, and it will call another function called nread. So an nread it will release the writer lock. So it is here. So it will first of all lock the reader, it will decrement nr. Then it will check if nr equal to 0, because initially it was incremented to 1. So it will check if it is 0, and then it will unset the writer lock and it will unset the read lock. So Meanwhile, different read threads are waiting for the lock to release. So as soon as this writer lock releases, next reader will come and it will increment NR, which was now made to zero. It will again become one, and it will the other locks, other threads will lock this writer, and they will read the content. And at the same time, writer locks are also there, so they are also waiting in that waiting for that lock on writer. So they will call this writer function. So as soon as this writer function is called, it will go to this function, and it will call start write. So it will come to start write, and it will try to lock writer. But there are reader threads; those are also locking this writer lock. So if that thread has locked writer, so then writer will have to wait for some time until unless reader releases the lock. And if there is no lock on the writer, then writer can lock this W, and it can read the content, or it can overwrite the content in the buffer, and it will again end write. So when it will call end write, it will release the lock. So here it is. So it releases the lock. So in this way it is being executed. So I will show you the execution of this program. So now I'm gonna execute that code in Fedora. So I have copy pasted that code in home directory, and I'm gonna execute it. So to compile it, first type gcc, then that code, the program name, that was rw.c, and we are using OpenMP, so we have to tell that we have to tell the compiler that we are using OpenMP. So for that, -f OpenMP and /a.out. So it is asking for the number of readers and writers. So suppose there are four readers and three writers. So I have to write something initially. So let's say com. So the program has read the content of the buffer for three times. So now we will override that content. So rescue to. So finally, one thread was remaining from the read. So the read thread then reads the overwritten data. So it has read the in the end. So in this way it is executing. So each time you give different input, it will execute according to the lock. So let's say 2 and 3. That's it. Thanks for watching, guys, and do subscribe.